only student at home and my esteemed parents, it's the holiday. Has been the holiday. I'm very sure that you are keeping safe and you're also maintaining your personal hygiene. Due to the lockdown that has prevented us from coming to school to have the normal school setting, now we are having the online training. So today, before we start, let me introduce myself to you. For those of you that don't know me, especially my parents, I'm Miss Elizabeth Adebayo. I'm the basic science teacher. So this morning, we'll be taking the first topic in our scheme of work for this term, and that is human reproduction. Human reproduction. Now, don't forget that in the first lesson that was taken while we were in the first term, we talked about characteristics of living things. If you remember, we mentioned a kind of acronym, Mr. Nigeria. Out of that acronym, which is the characteristics of living things, we mentioned reproduction. Reproduction. It is only a living thing that can do what? That can carry out this ability. That is reproduction. Knowing fully well that human being, you know yourself that you are a human being, you undergo reproduction as human being. So before we go deeply into what human reproduction is all about, what do you understand by reproduction? If you remember well, how I taught you then in that first time, we said reproduction is the ability of a living organism to give rise to its young one. A living organism to produce, to give rise to its young one is known as reproduction. Ability to give rise to young one. Is reproduction. So, human being as a living organism reproduce, give rise to its young one. That's why we are majorly focused on human reproduction today. Other animals too, that they are living, they give birth, they reproduce. But today, for this week, we'll be limiting it to human reproduction. So when we're talking about human reproduction, we're talking about the ability of human being to give birth to a young one. You will know too well that you did not fall from heaven. Is there anyone that fell from heaven? No, nobody fell from heaven. Someone gave birth to us. Someone gave birth to us. And it is very certain that at a point in time, you also do what? Give birth to another one. Your mother gave birth to you. You also will give birth to another person. So that is human reproduction. So we'll be talking about some terms that is connected to this human reproduction. Mind you, don't forget that the human race has two sex, which are opposite, the male and the female. So when we're talking about human reproduction, we'll be talking about the aspect of the male and the aspect of the female. But today, we'll limit our lesson to that of the female, female human reproduction. I hope you get me. So today, we'll be talking about some things that go on with the body of the female, of the female human, in which, if this does not occur, reproduction cannot take place. Reproduction, like I said, the ability to give rise to young one of our kind. It is not normal for a human being to give birth to goats, nor is it normal for a human being to give birth to birds. You must give birth to the human being exactly like you, because you are the one that is bringing it to life. Now, under this human reproduction, we'll be talking about one vital thing in the life of the female. Don't forget that we said that we'll be talking about the female aspect. One vital that is very important. If that does not occur, reproduction cannot take place. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. So at this stage, I want you, the girls, especially, to take note of what I'm saying. At this stage, the boys should not take notes. Take notes, because one way or the other, you have relationship with girls, with women. And don't forget that you also get married to a woman. So, concerning that, we'll be talking about menstruation. menstruation. Now, I'm very sure that all of you know this, you've heard about this before. Nobody.